The Bangles are the most successful all-female rock band in history. During the 1980s, the group had 3 multi-platinum albums and 8 top 40 hits in 9 countries, including 2 number one singles. Even the casual music listener is familiar with the Bangles through such songs as Manic Monday, Walk Like an Egyptian, and Eternal Flame. But one could argue that their most rock-influenced and musically sophisticated songs were overshadowed by their synth-pop and novelty concept mega-hits. Here, then, is a top 10 list of what I consider to be the most underrated Bangles songs that were not released as A-side singles and that reflect the band's musical sophistication as well as the songwriting talent of its members. Number 10, Want You. Written by Vicky and clearly showing the garage band roots of the Bangles, Want You comes from the Bangles' self-titled EP release of 1982. 1 year before bass guitarist Michael Steele joined the group. Fast and raw, Want You has a primal energy that supports straightforward lyrics with strong vocal harmonies, jamming guitars, and a variety of drum features by Debbie. Yeah, I want you. Number 9, He's Got a Secret. From the 1984 album All Over the Place, He's Got a Secret features verses in a mysterious minor key with a contrasting major key chorus. Michael provides a sulking bass line to highlight the lyrics regarding a secret that cannot be revealed. The marvelous four-part harmonies in the vocals lift the chorus into a major mode that is ultimately thwarted by a deceptive cadence, sending the music back into the dark minor mode. Number 8, Restless. Co-written by Susanna and Vicky, Restless describes a girl whose boyfriend has shown interest in another woman. She insists that while the decision to love someone else is his, she will not be deceived or lied to. The dark key of C minor is used throughout the song to depict the ominous clouds hovering over their relationship. I could trust you in any dark situation. Number 7, Bell Jar. From the 1988 Everything album, Bell Jar is about the life and death of poet and writer Sylvia Plath, author of The Bell Jar, who eventually committed suicide. Musically, the song alternates between upbeat and melancholy, possibly mirroring the manic depressive personality of Sylvia Plath. With some intense guitar work and the Bangles' trademark four-part vocals, Bell Jar is just as musically complex as it is poignant. Number 6, Let It Go. Written by all 4 Bangles, Let It Go is a straightforward rocker from the 1986 Different Light album. The basic chord progressions and minimal lyrics about letting go of a relationship when it is clearly over give the Bangles a chance to do what they do better than anyone else, four-part vocal harmony. Using chord suspensions, sevenths, and ninths throughout, this song is one of the reasons the Bangles were often dubbed as the female Fab Four. Number 5, Return Post. Co-written by Susanna and Vicky, Return Post is a marvelous contrast to the rest of the songs on the Different Light album. While the lyrics deal with a long-distance relationship that has run its course, The music features a swing style, large volume contrast between the verses and chorus, as well as the occasional use of Neapolitan chords to blur the harmonic stability, perhaps a metaphor for the uncertainty of the relationship described in the lyrics.
We'll have to figure out if this thing is real. And one of them is sitting on the wrong coast. One awaits an answer by the tough of waiting, waiting, waiting.
Number 4, James. Another early song by Vicky on the All Over the Place album, although sung by Susanna, James features a very simple chord progression throughout, with lyrics describing a relationship that wasn't what the singer thought it was going to be. The real magic of the song, however, is in the backing vocals with their rich four-part sonorities and an upbeat vocal vamp in place of a traditional guitar solo.
James.
Number 3, Glitter Years. Michael Steele's masterpiece from the 1988 Everything album, Glitter Years is a song in which an older but wiser musician reflects on past successes in a search for meaning. Poetic lyrics and complex chord progressions coupled with rich vocals and great solo work by Debbie and Vicky, Glitter Years is arguably Michael Steele's finest moment with the Bangles. Number 2, In a Different Light. Co-written by Vicky and Susanna, the title track to the Different Light album could potentially have been a hit single, had the album not already produced four other top 40 hits. The lyrics describe a changing relationship in which one person sees their partner's true self and finds it lacking. Alternating between the verses in C-sharp minor and a chorus in E major, the tone of the song changes from dark to light at the moment the lyrics describe the different and more enlightened perspective on the relationship. Rich in vocal harmonies, and with a relentless drive from start to finish, In a Different Light was the number one single that never was. Number 1, Crash and Burn. The final track of the Everything album, Crash and Burn is Vicki Peterson at her most raw and personal. In the lyrics, Vicki describes a situation spinning out of control and that she wants to escape from as fast as possible. Whether the song is about Vicki's personal life, the pressures of touring, or simply having a car accident after driving too fast, the music is filled with marvelous moments that lift this song far above a standard rocker. The backing vocals during the instrumental section cleverly resemble the sound of ambulance sirens. Coming out of the solo, the song becomes almost like a musical dreamscape and gives the impression of time standing still. Likewise, the use of irregular phrase lengths in the final verse contributes to the spinning out of control feel. The song ends abruptly, mid-sentence, on a chord that never resolves, leaving the listener with a sudden and unexpected conclusion. Crash and Burn is quite possibly the Bangles' best rock song ever. Do you have a favorite underrated Bangles song? Feel free to list it in the comments. Most of all, enjoy the Bangles and their mind-bangling music.
Yesterday, by tomorrow, you'll see the tomorrow.